Hello, farmers. My name is Rever. Well, not really, but my screen name is Rever. Welcome to Lakeside Map by Stevie, version 1.1. I've done a little bit with Giant's editor. I'll show you later to add some fertilizer tanks. I've also edited some of the pricing at the sell points. I'm in hard mode, but sometimes I think hard mode, by the time you spray the fertilizers, you really don't make any money on the field, so I edited up the amounts sort of randomly. What we're sitting on is field 2-3, I call it. I combine these two fields, and I haven't owned these fields long. I've been on this map for about 10 days, and this is what I'll do to try to get things balanced back out so the whole field is pretty much even. Well, it'll be real even. So right at this point, I'm standing on what was field 2, and you can see that all of my nutrients, except for the pH, are at 0. And I've found that this is the most economical way to zero out your field. So let me come over to the edge here. If you see this down in the bottom corner, I'm standing on what was grass before, and this is all zeroed. So this way, when I bring this field back up, everything will be, you know, pretty much even, like I said. So without further ado, I'll zap over into my tractor and talk about it for a minute. Wrong tractor. This is my little sprayer tractor, which I guess in real life wouldn't be that little, but... And if you see, I've used the in-game spreader. I'll show you eventually when we do the next spraying. Well, actual spraying as opposed to spreading. Why I use this. I'll set this, if you see I have my course play open. And the width is set to 24. So the reason I do that is when I come back, I am using drive control, and I'll create tram lines eventually. It doesn't really matter so much for this, but I thought I would show you. As a matter of fact, I'll probably take it, make it 26 before it's over, because I'm going to end up cultivating. So really the big point to this is I'll show you that going from 0 within the 4 days, we can get this field back up. Everything will be right except for the soil pH. By the time we're done, we'll go back down to 6.6. So let me adjust my course play at this point. And I'm gonna, usually what I'll do is I'll zoom out far enough, swing my view over, and then line this up so that I'm right on the edge of the field. Let me increase the width. Yes, I wish you could. That's probably, if anything, I want to be a tiny bit under. There you go. That's probably close enough. So I'll take this red line. I don't know if you can see it too well, but I'm going to bring that red line right over as I'm looking down the field edge, as close as reasonably possible. And use this GPS mod is wonderful for spraying. Prevents a lot of overspray. Alright, so there we are. So we're talk about what I'm doing. See, I'm going up the hill a little bit slow here. This tractor's a little bit underpowered on these bigger hills, but that's alright. Since we're spraying the lime, what I'm going to do is then cultivate that lime in. I have a cultivator all ready to go. What that will give me is 0.8 pH added to, so it should bring me all the way up to, you know, in the neighborhood of 7.2. Now when these, I'm going to plant wheat in this field, when the crops grow, it's going to bring back down the pH just because of the crops by 0.2, so that'll get me down to 0.7 even, and then when I get to spraying more herbicide, that's going to bring down another 0.2, so now I'm down to 6.8. Make my turn. Not driving off the hill. So now we're down to 6.8 because I sprayed my herbicide BB on my wheat field, which I'll get into later on. Not that the herbicide's that complicated. And then in order to get this field up, I'm going to have to spray two nitrogens because, again, I'm at zero, so that'll give me five each time, bring me up to 10. And at that point, I'll lose 0.4 for spraying the herbicide. I'm sorry, for spraying the nitrogen. Which will bring me back down to 6.6. There's really not another option there because, you know, I don't want to spray lime twice, though I probably could get up to 7.2, but that's a little bit further away from 6.8 than if I had just left it at 6.6, which is obviously only, you know, one level, 0.2 off. If you just lay if I were to lay this lime on there, it'll be 0.6. Next time, next time I do this field, that's probably what I'll end up doing because it's a little bit unusual, unless you're zero in the field, to spray two nitrogens right in a row. If I had manure or slurry, enough of that, you could end up maybe getting away with one coat of that, and then you wouldn't have to worry about the pH hit as much. Be the ideal world, but I haven't really got my animals going on this farm yet. So, to discuss more about what I'm going to do is really pretty straightforward. I'm spraying two coatings of PK and two coatings of N. So that's going to be what I do once each day. You can't spread any more than one nutrient per day, but I can spread this lime and cultivate it in, or whether I cultivate it in or not, is it going to really affect? I could still spray the N or the PK on the same day. Now the other issue that I'm going to have is that my soil moisture is at zero. So what I'll do is come in and spray water on three of the days. So today, for example, first I'm going to cultivate this, then I'm going to plant, then I'm going to spray my nitrogen, then I'm going to spray my herbicide, then I'm going to spray water. Maybe not in that exact order, but so I'll spray four things on this one day, or spread this nitrogen out, and then spray three more things, and that's all good. That won't hurt you. Well, since this is exciting, and it's just the very beginning, I'll come back after I've gotten done this spraying, and I'll show you the effect that the cultivator has. All right, see you in a bit. Hello guys, back, you can't tell. Just about done spreading the lime on this field. You can see, maybe from my course play, or my GPS line over there, that I'm going to have this little stupid 1 meter, 2 meter strip, so I'll have to run back down and spread as we go along back towards the farm anyway. So, as you can see, this is a decent sized field. This spreader does a pretty good job. It holds a good amount. Means you don't have to refill. It's not so important. I mean, it's nice to not have to refill, but when you get into fields that don't have as much headland space, it's awful nice because then you don't end up doing any extra crop destruction at that point. What I'm going to do when we get done this is hop over into the cultivator and we can start cultivating a little bit. say I really do enjoy the challenge that the soil mod adds to the maps. It's something that Giant should consider for future updates. I mean, and, you know, besides just spraying fertilizer on a field, I mean, there's certainly a lot of room for improvement on soil quality. It'd be kind of cool if you could even change the type of soil. I hear people talking about, you know, and I just know from life that, you know, soil quality in general could be something that could be adjustable. You know, every field in every map, to a degree, has the same exact soil quality. Well, you know, certain areas I know of the United States, I'm sure it's true in Europe, you know, you got farms that have great fields, the best dirt in the world kind of stuff. Alright, so we'll jump on this. It'd be good if you could adjust the field. You could even do it within a map, you know, maybe on this hillside the dirt may not be quite as good as down in the low area of the farm. Add a little extra thought. Hey, I want to plant this crop. Turn on my GPS mod, of course. Here's another little trick. If you have the course play, which I know a lot of people do, you can use this to click the buttons over here, even though you don't intend to do the course play. Sort of took me a while to figure that out without hitting the control. You can see I have that tractor selector mod, so that stupid thing pops up. But in any event, if you see my pretty good lined up, that's just sort of happened, I guess. It's a separate tractor, so I didn't do that ahead of time, just got lucky. Do I have the right width? Yeah, this is 9 meter. I always, not always, but we'll double check in here. Let's go back to, there it is. Up 10 meters, see? So it's good to check. Let's go back and that. Like I said, I wish they would make it so I could type this in. That would be nice if they're listening. And I threw off my offset. Not real great with, as much as I've used the GPS mod, I'm not real great with it. But there we go. We're probably close enough now. Set my W. Get rid of this. And off we go. Alright, as you can see, this is real exciting. Let's see about increasing. I think if you set your cruise control for lower, then it won't get up to speed. I guess I was probably following a combine with this tractor and tried to set it 6. Now I got it up to 4 next time I'm on the road. This will go a lot faster. It's just this hill is causing this. Probably turn on differentials, why not? To be honest, I turn those on and off. I know they help me get unstuck once in a while, but other than that, I'm not real sure. There you go, see my speed's getting up to 6 and 7. So I do a couple rows here, I'll show you what we're doing. So if you see, I'm getting a 6.5 reading on my pH, and that's more likely because it's picking up some of that grass. That grass field's a little different. The pH is not as hypersensitive as far as, you know, if you look at the chart, dropping the pH by 0.2 or even that 0.1 that you can see there is really only going to have a very minimal effect. 3% is what I've calculated, and, you know, when you're off to point, like when we're done with this map, 6.6 is going to be what we're going to end up at. Well, we'll lose 3% off of our bonus at that point. So it's, oops, slow down, ahead of myself. Alright, so we'll get back to doing this row, then I can hop out and show you the effect we're having behind us. Close enough. Just hop out real quick. So if I come over to here, you can see we're at 6.5 or 6.6. When I worry, I don't worry about the odd numbers. I'll just look at 6.6. So if I come over to here, look how it jumps up to 7.3. And again, I'm really probably reading a little bit of whatever's going on over here, bringing it back down. So there you go. It's maybe if I come up where we've done two lanes, which is why I switched, why I did the second one, and come right in here and maybe get a better reading. And you can see I'm at 7.3 at that point. Again, for my calculations, I'll end up considering that 7.2 usually, just because the spreadsheet I made up, that I calculate what the fields are doing, they're at, you know, so I just do the even numbers. It's close enough for government work, as they say. So I'll hop back into this tractor and get back to cultivating this field. I don't think there's any reason to torture you guys with the cultivating of this whole field. It'll take me a while. I'll do it manually. Though, to be honest, we'll see. Maybe I will switch it over to course play. And course play, I don't mind doing the course play, because even if it misses, it's not like I have a tram line issue. I can just go back over it in the end. But so as you can see, we've just with one spreading, we'll get our soil pH effectively up to 7.2, and that'll be more or less good enough to get us in a good range when this field's finally done. Like I said, I'll spray the two nitrogens, a herbicide, and lose one for the crop. So I'm going to lose all this 0.8 or so that I gained, 0.9, whatever it is. I'm going to end up losing that whole thing just with get right back down. But then, you know, next time I plant this field, I'm certainly not going to spray two N's, I'm sure. If you spray NPK or PK, it doesn't take anything off. So anyway, well, let me finish up this field. Like I said, I may, now that I think about it, I'm going to set it up for course play. Once he gets ahead of me far enough, I'll I'll start doing the sowing. And when I get close to spraying the next allotment, I'll bring you guys back. All right. Again, see you in a bit. I'm back just for a brief second here. Maybe more than a second, of course. I want to mention, this Pronto Horst, yeah, I guess it's a Horst seeder, which is wonderful. It's supposed to cultivate and seed at the same time. I wanted to point out to you guys, and now my case magnum is slipping, it's been doing that the whole time, not making things any faster here. Hop over there and get him fixed. Now he's doing it on the other side of the hill, before he was doing it on. I really, really wish you could adjust how they turn at the end. I haven't really looked for an update to course play, but I think one of the best things they could do for course play is adjust that. There's some other issues with chasers, but in any event. Alright, so that was a little distraction, but I wanted to point out that I'm cultivating, and the reason is, with a real cultivator, if I just use this Horst, it doesn't actually, it's like what I'll call a surface cultivation. So it's not going to drive the lime into the soil. You can see there's a few spots, well, one in particular right here, that was missed by the real cultivator. And if you notice, the lime is still sitting in that one spot. Here, no lime. Here, lime. So when it comes to the alkalinity of this area, raising the soil pH, it's only going to get 0.6. It's not going to get, you know, 0.8. So keep that in mind, that if you do want to get the full effect of the lime, then you're going to need to run a real cultivator over it. A lot of times that's not going to matter to you, because to be honest, most of the time I just lay it on top and get my 0.6, and that tends to balance things out. And in this case, it's a little extreme because we zeroed the field. And there goes that guy slipping again. So, all right, I'm going to cut out and Again, be back when I'm almost done and go fix this guy once again. Back to field 2 and 3 here, and I just saw my video. You probably got my note in the beginning, and I noticed that it was awful choppy. If you see this point, if I drive around in a circle, this little segment's, you know, probably relatively smooth, certainly compared to the last one. So it's also added up the amount of time. It's been 39 minutes, 40 minutes, so it's probably long enough for a first episode. I have no idea what I'm getting into to try to actually get this on YouTube. So again, we will say goodbye for now, and I'll have episode 2, and hopefully everything will be smoother, and hopefully you don't have a headache if you did watch this whole video. All right, take care, and have a good day. Alrighty guys, I'm back. The field is pretty much seeded. Just one last little strip. And then, you know, we can move on to other things. I fought with that cultivator the entire time, and I don't know if you noticed my money before, but $60,000 less and a new fancy 12-meter cultivator. I haven't really even looked and see how he's doing on his ends of the rows, but it can't be any worse than course play stopping at the edge of almost every lane just slipping. So I'll go say it could have been the tractor. That tractor has a front attachment, so I can't put any other weight than what looks like comes with it. So, but again, if a cultivator is going to stop every lane just because the field's a little bit hilly, it's probably course play's fault, you could argue, but who cares? Not worth the aggravation. So there we go. That field is now seeded in wheat. Take a look at it. Pop out right here. So there we go. So you can see we have no soil moisture, no nitrogen, no PK, but we've got our soil pH up to 7.5, which again I'll usually count as 7.4. We added, without even waiting for the midnight thing, we've added 0.8, 0.9 to the whole field. So, again, this will put us, when we go through spraying 2 nitrogens, the crop loss, we'll lose that 0.8, and we should be down to, you know, about 6.7, 6.6, which will get us to, you know, a very nice, you know, a little bit lower than we want, but hey, we're going to lose 3% based on that, so really not a big deal. Alright, so we'll turn off our course play and we'll go drop this off at the farm. Talking about Lakeside Map for a second. It's a nice map for course play, other than that stupid cultivator. Generally speaking, you got big headlands, you got nice square fields, and all the fields are also on a 90 degree, you know, they're due east, west, north, south, so when you set up your course play, you don't have any big issues. Fields are on diagonals. I've played harder maps, and I don't know, I like the challenge, but it's also kind of nice sometimes to just relax a bit, have things square, and not worry about the course play hitting every tree in the county. Like I said, I haven't looked for an update to course play. By the way, this map has the seed master, you can see. I'll just stop here real quick. May even leave him here and zap over to back to my sprayer tractor. So we'll take this guy. And I'll show you a feature that this was the first map I've actually seen these on. They have a mod called Soil Mod Tanks. And Soil Mod Tanks are pretty darn nice. And the reason that they're so nice is that when it comes to filling up with the big blue tank, you got to switch to the NPK. And if you're like me, sometimes you forget to switch back and you end up spraying your field with NPK on one part and nitrogen on the other. that happens to you, it's not really that big a deal. Just go back and respray what you didn't spray initially, and whatever you spray second is going to take over. So if I forgot to spray, you know, if I was spraying nitrogen and I forgot to switch back and I got NPK in there, then all of a sudden I would, you know, at that point I would just go back with the nitrogen and just spray over it, and everything would be hunky-dory. So anyway, here I am at the lime tank. These are the soil mod tanks. You can see each one contains a different thing. You'd see this one says lime, and you kind of see N and PK and NPK. And again, when I fill up with the lime, you know, that's the only thing I can get out of this tank too, by the way. So if you get in the habit of going to the right one, you'll not mess yourself up. And I'm just, you know, showing you this. This is the ones that the map maker, Stevie, had added to the map. I didn't even realize he had these in this barn. I guess I had driven around. You can see this barn's kind of not hidden, but it's off to the side corner of this main farm. I didn't really drive back in there and notice when I had first opened the map. And it's just not many maps have those tanks. So I ended up, you know, saying, well, let me add them. So I added some tanks just outside the main farm. Another thing that's real nice about these tanks is that they, you can course play with them if you modify the course play at that point. Now I forget where I my spreader, but or this is the spreader, the sprayer. There it is over there. See it behind the bush. I'll just go park this guy back over here. I'm not going to need him. I've got two fields today that are starting out, so I really never spread lime other than on the, you know, after the planting or before or after the planting. So let's drop this guy off. Now this mod sprayer is pretty darn wonderful. It sprays 24 like the in-game, but you can drive 12 miles an hour, which I'm sure you guys have sprayed fields at 7, and boy, that's annoying. At least for me it is anyway. So this lets you do 12 miles an hour. You're still only spraying 24, but if you think about the added speed that you get, it actually becomes the equivalent of spraying with that with the bigger 42 meter sprayer. And I have to think about, what are we doing? Okay, we're going to spray nitrogen. Oh, I'm sorry. Let's spray water first, and we'll head back over to our field 2-3. With some water in here. So see, I'll pull up to my water tank. Now you'll notice I'm down to 81% in the bottom right, and I'm going to hit the R button. So I'm hitting R and I can't fill up from this tank. I can't put A in there. Even if I go over to NPK and I'm going to hit R again, there I'm hitting it. See, it won't fill up. It's only when I go back over to the water symbol that it'll let me fill it up. So if you're doing a course play and you want to come up to one of these, if it has some of the water in it already, it'll automatically fill, just like any other, you know, course play thing where it drives past the load point. At the same time, if the tank is empty, and as long as you don't pass any of the other ones, you see I have those tanks in a row, so I just make sure my course doesn't overlap another tank, it'll just fill up water as it drives past it, and we'll be able to spray it. We'll be able to fill it. So now we're heading back over to field 2-3. I think what I might do real quick here, once I get through the gate, let's just stop for a second. And then we're going to bounce over. I just want to check real quick the job this guy's doing, particularly at the end of the field. So there's my new cultivator. Hasn't gotten stuck once. And this field, the ends of it are relatively flat. And after fixing on the other field 12 times, I said, oh, to heck with this. And I ended up just buying this one. So kind of glad I did. And look, he's doing a good job. Very little left on the ends. So I'll just maybe clean those up, maybe not. It's really not that big a deal either way. So good. Our new cultivator is doing a much better job than my old one. and he's almost done cultivating. Now you notice on this field, if you look at our moistures, you know, 60%, which is basically 57, and we're at 7. Again, I always round to the even number on my soil pH. That's pretty, you know, one off. I'll consider that. And that means I'm going to lose about 3, or I lost 3% when I did this field. Now, this field is one of the ones that, because my nitrogen's at 10, if I try to spray two NPKs to try to get that PK back up to 6, so it comes back down to 4, I'm going to end up, you know, with a total of 16 nitrogen. Well, I lose 4 during the normal cycle of this is a sugar beets field. That means that I would be at 12 ending on my nitrogen, which 10 is the cutoff. Like 10 and 4, because I was at 4, I didn't lose anything. But if I was at 10, I lose 25%. Now, if my PK goes to 5, I lose 25% because my key PK is at 5. So what I'm going to do on this field this time is just spray like 1 PK, and then I'll spray my normal herbicide. So I say all of that because what I'll also end up having to do with this field is spray water. And each crop rotation, you end up losing 3 water. So I'm going to end up spraying herbicide and water, which will get me up 28%. Doesn't add. You don't get 14 for the herbicide being liquid, and then plus the 28 for the water. You just get 28 kind of for the water at that point. And then when I add my PK to it tomorrow, if I spread the PK, that'll add another 14%. And then when the whole map finishes, I'll end up right at 57. So anyway, I might as well wait a few seconds here and let this guy finish. We'll come back and you know, take a look at maybe each of the fields as we go along, because they'll give you different examples of where the whole process is at and my soil mod thinking as far as that goes. Okay, so that, I'm very impressed with that cultivator compared to the other one. Close this course up and get a little bit out of the way. Back and so because I'm not, so in other words, I guess what I started saying too was, you know, my soil pH on the field is 7, and I'm going to lose 0.2 for the growth, and then I'm going to lose 0.2 for the herbicide, but so that'll get me to 6.6. It's really not worth spraying the lime because that would put me to 7.2 or so, which would be further off than if I just did nothing. So I'd rather be at 6.6. A lot of the nutrients don't like to be below, and they don't, you know, the penalty for being slightly above is usually less. Like the nitrogen, you get a pretty good penalty if you're down at 4 or 3, but you don't get, on the top side, on going above it, I mean, 10 is about the equivalent of being at 3. So I think in both of those cases, you lose 25%. Bonus. Alright, so I'm not going to bother to park this well. I'll do that off camera at some point. And then we can jump back over into, actually now I want to go to this. I bought a new horsed, you know, the bigger soybean and corn planter. But I want to run the seed out of this, waste not, want not. So real quick. Well, actually, you know what I'm going to do first before I forget. You can see I already have my horse play open. And I'm pretty sure it's adjusted to the right width. Horse play tends to miss, as you guys probably know. But horse play also, if you have this crop destruction on with the drive control mod, it doesn't... I'm sorry about that. You know, the horse play doesn't cause drive control to destroy the crop. So what I usually like to do is come and make a swath or two here, especially when I'm doing beets or corn. Like this planter doesn't recultivate. So when I said that the cultivator, you know, you have to do the surface cultivation. Well, surface cultivation counts. Oops, there's some misplaces with the cultivator, so we lost that little bit. That's okay. The cultivator on the planter does work in terms of this crop destruction. So if you drive over an area, you know, in your planting, you just have to drive back over it with the planter down and running, and it'll get rid of your crop destruction. So by doing this, and then I turn on the coarse play to have him seed the rest of the field, what'll happen is I won't get all those missed edges, and he won't do crop destruction. I don't really consider that cheating, because, you know, if I hired someone to do the field and they didn't get the ends, I would be kind of annoyed at them. But again, coarse play doesn't really do a good job of turning, or at least let you adjust the turning at the end. So yeah, maybe they'll add that one day. Seems like a complicated enough mod. I appreciate the guys making it, just having it as a general rule. So anyway, so I'll get this guy going, and then probably rejoin you when I get over back to field 2-3 with the water, and I'll show you what happens with that now. Okay, see you in a bit. Back to field 2 and 3 here, and I just saw my video. You probably got my note in the beginning, and I noticed that it was awful choppy. If you see this point, if I drive around in a circle, this little segment's, you know, probably relatively smooth, certainly compared to the last one. So it's also added up the amount of time. It's been 39 minutes, 40 minutes, so it's probably long enough for a first episode. I have no idea what I'm getting into to try to actually get this on YouTube. So again, we will say goodbye for now, and I'll have episode 2, and hopefully everything will be smoother, and hopefully you don't have a headache if you did watch this whole video. All right, take care, and have a good day.